إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters, one of the main things in our religion to believe that the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-Sahaba, they are the best generation. They are between the Ummah and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They conveyed the whole religion to the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you respect them, this means you respect Islam and you love Islam. And if you disrespect them or one of them, this means there is a problem in your Islam. And one of the great companions, all of them are great, but one of the greatest companion, Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala an. Uthman, the third Khalifa after Abu Bakr and Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. Uthman, the husband of two daughters of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ruqayya and Kulthum radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. Uthman, one of the companions who accepted Islam at the beginning, early Islam, the first few days. Abu Bakr, Uthman, Zubayr, Abdurrahman, Awf, Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, he was one of them. Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. I'll mention a few verses about Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, because as I mentioned, to believe that the companions are the best people, this is part of our Islam. The scholars mention this point in the books of Aqidah, the books of talking about faith and the right belief. And a hadith, authentic hadith by Tirmidhi rahimahullahu ta'ala anhu. جاء عثمان رضي الله تعالى عنه with, he came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم with 1,000 dinar. This was in the ninth year when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم urged the Muslim, we should collect money, where is your charity to fight the kuffar in Tabuk? And this army called Jaysh al-Usra. Why? Because it was tough and difficult, and the distance far, and the enemy strong. They mentioned the army of Muslim 10,000, and they were maybe 200,000, the kuffar. We need money. We need camels, horses, swords. So everyone brought what he can, maybe few pieces of dates. Uthman brought to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam 1,000 dinar. And when we say 1,000 dinar, doesn't mean our dinar now, Kuwaiti dinar, Bahraini dinar. 1 dinar, it is gold, about 4.25 grams of gold. Yani 1 dinar, about 80 dinar now. So what is the value of 10,000 dinar of gold? What is the value of 10,000 dinar, or sorry, 1,000 dinar of gold? This is maybe 100,000 or 90,000 dinar. He brought this to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he put this gold in the lap of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He poured this money in the lap of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turning them over in his lap, he was happy to see this much of charity to prepare the army. Then he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ما ضر عثمان ما عمل بعد اليوم. ما ضر عثمان ما عمل بعد اليوم. Whatever Uthman does after today will not harm him. He repeated this twice. Which means this charity will clear off all of his sins. He will be in paradise, no doubt. رضي الله تعالى عنه. Another hadith about Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه. عبد الرحمن عوف said when Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه was circled, he looked upon them from above and said, because he was killed by the Khawarij and they accused him, rumors, lies. So he told them, Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه, you are not witness when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من حفر روما فله الجنة فحفرتها. There was a well called Ruma, and the water became less in this well. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, who dig this well, lahu al-jannah, for him, paradise. And I did that. Subhanallah. I did that. من حفر روما فله الجنة. فحفرتها. I did that. Which means, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam promised me paradise. رضي الله تعالى عنه. But subhanallah, they killed him. Because they were Khawarij, bad people. Another hadith also about paradise for Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم one day was in a place called Bi'r Aris, a well called Aris. So he went inside and he sat there. Then Abu Musa al-Ash'ari رضي الله تعالى عنه, Abdullah ibn Qais, said, I will guard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Abu Bakr came. He said, please wait here, I will take the permission for you. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, give him the permission and give him glad tidings, he will be in paradise. Then Umar came, the same thing, he gave him the paradise. Aidan lahu bashirhu bil jannah. Give him the permission to enter and tell him, glad tidings for you, paradise, jannah. When Uthman came radiyallahu ta'ala an, he said, اذن له او افتح له وبشره بالجنه على بلوى تصيبه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to Abu Musa al-Ash'ari رضي الله تعالى عنه, give him glad tidings of entering paradise and also inform him of what, and inform him that will be with a calamity. And subhanAllah, this happened. When he died, رضي الله تعالى, he was killed by the Khawarij, and this is a big calamity, and he was shaheed, رضي الله تعالى عنه. Uthman bin Affan, he has something unique, subhanAllah. One day the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was with Aisha, رضي الله تعالى عنها, and he was sitting as the person with his wife. Then Abu Bakr came and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did not change his position. Part of his leg or part of his knees was uncovered. Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه entered and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did not change his position. But when Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه came in, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم changed his position and he covered his knees or his thighs. When he left, Aisha wondered رضي الله تعالى عنها. Or Rasulullah Abu Bakr came, Umar came at the same position. But when Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه entered, you change your position and you covered yourself. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, ألا استحي من رجل تستحي منه الملائكة. Should I not show modesty to one whom even the angels show modesty? The scholars mentioned that because Abu Bakr can ask what he likes from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He can chat with him freely. Also Umar. But Uthman, because of his shyness, his modesty, if he sees the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his position, he will not ask him. So that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I should be modest with Uthman more because the angels tastahi minhu. One day he was on the mountain of Uhud. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman. The greatest people that time. The greatest. Then the mountain of Uhud moved and some shaking. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam kicked the mountain and he said, firm Uhud, uthbut Uhud, nama alayka nabi wa siddiq wa shahidan. You should be firm on you, a prophet, a siddiq, truthful, and two shaheed, Umar and Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, because they were killed and they killed as a shaheed, Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, by Abu Lu'lu al-Majusi during the Salah, Fajr Salah, and Uthman by the Khawarij, so they were killed as shaheed. أقول ما تسمعون الحمد لله. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد. One of the great virtues of Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala an, brothers and sisters, it is important to know their virtues, because if you know the virtues of the companions, you love them more. And loving the companions, part of our religion, we have to love them. Loving the companions is a sign of your faith, but if you hate the companions, it's a sign of your hypocrisy. Subhanallah. So when you read about their virtues, you know them more, you love them more. رضي الله تعالى عنهم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved in the Quran by Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه. عند حديث حذيفة بن اليمان came to the خليفة عثمان. This is during the خلافة after the death of عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه. And he noticed something and immediately he told عثمان. He said, the Muslims are differing now because of the قراءات, because of the different narrations of the Quran, and people don't know, sometimes they don't know this is a correct narration, so they fight because they don't know. Oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, you should do something to protect them, we don't want to differ like the people before us, the Jews and the Christians. So Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala sent to Hafsa, because she has the book, she has the Quran, because the Quran was collected at the time of Abu Bakr radiyallahu ta'ala an. Then again at the time of Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala an, and he made 6 or 7 copies and he sent these copies to the cities of Islam that time, and he burned the other than that. And he said to Zayd ibn Thabit and certain companions, okay, you should agree on something, and if you differ you should follow harf Quraysh, the way of Quraysh, because there are 7 ahruf of the Quran. So by that, alhamdulillah, Allah preserved the Quran by the action of Uthman al-Affan radiyallahu ta'ala an, and this is as a consensus from the companions during that time. When he burned the other Quran and he kept one Quran, where the companions agreed upon this Quran. Until today, alhamdulillah, we read the same Quran, al-Mushaf al-Uthmani, from Uthman, the time of Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala an. Uthman was a very soft man. His heart, emotional toward the Akhirah. They asked him, radiyallahu ta'ala an, yani they notice when Uthman visits the graves, he cries. But when they mention the Quran, the hellfire paradise, he is not emotional like that. So they asked him, they wondered. Uthman told that when he stood over a grave, he would weep. As subhanallah, the tears moistured his beard. So when he was asked, you remember paradise and hell without weeping, yet you are weeping over this, which means the grave. He said, radiyallahu ta'ala an, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الْقَبْرَ أَوَّلَ مَنْزِلٍ مِّن مَنَازِلِ الْآخِرَةِ. The grave is the first stage of the next world. If one escapes from it, what falls is easier than it. What follows is easier than it. But if one doesn't escape from it, what follows is more severe than it. Because this is the sign of what comes after that. If the grave, you are okay, you are happy, you see your righteous deeds, so what comes after that will be easier. But if you are struggling, punishment, منكر ومنكير punishing you in the grave, then what comes after that, it will be harder. So Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه was a righteous man. Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه used to recite the Quran in one rak'ah, in the witr, one rak'ah in witr, which means there is a strong relationship with him, with the Quran, between him and the Quran رضي الله تعالى عنه. Reading the Quran, crying رضي الله تعالى عنه. Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه was a just man. Something happened from his brother. They told him that your brother did so and so. A brother from his mother. And two witnesses came and he punished his brother. Subhanallah. Why? Because justice is more important than the brotherhood. Even if you are my brother, but you did a mistake and there are witnesses, I have to follow the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he was a just Khalifa Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minin wal mu'minat wal muslimin wal muslimat الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا, كره إلينا الكفر والفسوق العصيان. جعلنا اللهم من راشدين. اللهم ارفع عنا الوباء والغلاء يا رب العالمين. احفظ الشباب والبنات من المخدرات ومن الزنا والخنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا الأحياء منهم والأموات, واشف مرضانا مرضى المسلمين. اللهم نجي إخواننا المسلمين من كل مكان. اللهم احرر المسجد الأقصى من يد اليهود, واجعل صلاة المسلمين فيه صلاة آمنة مطمئنة يا رب العالمين. اجمع المسلمين على السنة والتوحيد, وفق ولاة أمورنا لما تحب وترضى, والحمد لله رب العالمين.